Good morning, students. So in today's class, we are going to revise the lesson number 4, that is the natural symbols. Natural symbols. So in this lesson, first we will discuss about the national flag, and then see here. First, we will discuss about the national flag. And then next, about the national flag. National emblem. National emblem. Next, national emblem. Then about the other symbols. Other symbols. Okay. So we have already studied all of these topics in the regular classes. In today's class, we are going to revise these all contents one more time. Okay. So first, you know that we will discuss about the national flag. Before that, you know that we are belonging to a country is called India, and of course India is a very big, vast and beautiful country. And in this country, in our country, there are so many national symbols are there. And some of them are national flag, national emblem, national anthem, and some of the other symbols are there as well. Okay, so let's study all of these one by one. So if we talk about first national flag, we have a national flag, and there are three colors in our national flag. Those are the saffron at the top, white in the middle, and green at the bottom. And in the middle of flag, we are having Ashoka Chakra, which is having 24 spokes, and the color of this chakra is navy blue. Okay, and our national flag is the symbolize. It's what it symbolizes. It symbolizes freedom and unity. Our national symbol, national flag, symbolizes freedom and unity, and it is also called as Tirunga. National flag is also called as Tirunga. Okay, and next also the color, the saffron color symbolizes the courage and sacrifice. Next, white, which is middle in the national flag, symbolizes peace and truth and peace, and the dark green symbolizes prosperity. Okay, and in the center of the flag, there is a navy blue chakra, which called as Ashoka Chakra, which is having 24 spokes, and that Ashoka Chakra symbolizes growth and progress. Okay, so this is something about the national. So next, we discuss about national emblem. You know that Ashoka was a great king of the Maurya dynasty. Of course, Ashoka was a very great king of the Maurya dynasty. And during his rule, he built the Ashoka Pillara. He built Ashoka Pillara at Sarnath, so which was a stone pillar. Basically, it was a stone pillar with four loins. Which are facing four directions. Like one is towards the east, and there one is towards the west, one more is towards the north, and another one is towards the south. Four loins were facing the four directions. And on the national emblem, they have written like Satyameva Jayate. Satyameva Jayate is written on the national emblem. And what is the meaning of Satyameva Jayate? Truth alone trumps. Truth alone
satyamev jayate deem. Okay, so this is something about national apple. So next we will revise about the national anthem. You know that our national anthem is Jana Gana Mana. Of course, Jana Gana Mana is our national anthem. And see here, Jana Gana Mana. And who was written? It is Jana Gana Mana was written by Rabindranath Tagore. Okay. So originally it was written in Bengali. Okay. So our national anthem is Jana Gana Mana, and it was composed by Rabindranath Tagore. And you know that originally our national anthem was written in the Bengali. And there were originally it was having 5 stanzas. Originally it was having more than 5 stanzas, but we have selected only 5 stanzas among of them. And of course this national anthem it symbolizes, okay, national anthem symbolizes unity. Unity, okay, it symbolizes unity, and as a mark of respect, we must stand in attention whenever the national anthem is being played or sung. When the national anthem is being played or being sung, we should stand in attention. Okay, that is the rule. So, this is about national anthem. Now, it's time to study about other symbols. So what is the meaning of other symbols? Other symbols are, first one, national animal, national heritage animal, national bird, national flower, national song, national aquatic animal. Okay, so mainly there are 6 other symbols. Okay, let's study them one by one. So here, see, first one, national animal. National animal. Next one is national heritage animal. National heritage animal. Okay, next, national bird. And next, national flower. National flower. Next, national song. National song. Next, national aquatic animal. National aquatic animal. Okay. So yes, these are the 6 other symbols. So let's study them one by one. First we will discuss about the national animal. So what is our national animal? The Royal Bengal Tiger. Okay, the Royal Bengal Tiger is our national animal. And of course, we must save the tigers to prevent their extinction. And our government has already started that is called Project Tiger. See, our government has already a program is called as Project Tiger to save our tigers. Okay, so that is about national animal. Next, about national heritage animal. Our national heritage animal is nothing but elephant. And this heritage animal in October 2010, government has announced that elephant is our national heritage animal, and this will help protect the unique species from getting extinct. That is about the national heritage animal. Next one is national bird. So our national bird is nothing but a peacock. Peacock is our national bird, and it is the symbol of pride and beauty. And this bird is also protected by the government, and peacock helps our farmers by eating insects and snakes. Okay, so it means, of course, in the fields there are so many snakes and insects are there, which causes the damages to the crops. So these peacocks helps the farmer by eating snakes and insects. That's about the national bird. Next one, national flower. Our national flower is nothing but lotus. Okay, and it is found in different colors. Of course, this lotus flower is found in different colors like pink and white. It is available in two colors, so that is pink and white, and it grows in marshy areas. This national flower grows in marshy areas, and a lotus plant has broad leaves. The leaves of the lotus plant is very broad, and it is a symbol of beauty and dignity. Lotus flower is the symbol of purity and dignity. Okay. Next is about national flower, next national song. So our national song is Vande Mataram. Vande Mataram is our national song, and it was written by Bankim Chandra Chatterjee. And originally this Vande Mataram was written in the Bengali and Sanskrit languages, and it played a key role in the Swadeshi movement, because during the Swadeshi movement the Vande Mataram song was sung by the freedom fighters in 1905. Was about national song. The last one, national aquatic animal, okay, dolphin. Dolphin is our national aquatic animal in the, and of course our government has declared that national aquatic animal as dolphin on 18th March 2010, and it is the symbol of purity. Dolphin is the symbol of purity of Ganga river, because it only survives in the fresh water. Dolphin survives only in the fresh water, and it is found in the rivers like Ganga, Meghna, Brahmaputra and Karnapuli rivers, because all these rivers are very pure. Okay, that's because this dolphin animal is aquatic animal is survived only in the fresh water. And of course, it is distributed in Nepal, Bhutan, Bangladesh, which are besides India. Okay, so this is about the national aquatic animal. So this was the lesson about national symbols, about national flag, national emblem, national anthem, and some other symbols. Other symbols are nothing but national animal, national heritage animal, national bird, national flower, national song, and last one, national aquatic animals. Okay. So here the revision of the lesson number 4, national symbols, are completed. Now they have given some of the questions here, like multiple choice questions, fill in the blanks, answer the following in one word, answer the following questions. And already we have discussed all of these questions and answers in the online class, as well as I'm sending you or already sent all the questions and answers of this lesson in your WhatsApp in a PDF form. So if your fair is not completed on this lesson, if you have not written the question and answer, just open your WhatsApp. You can open the group of the school, group of your class. You can prompt the question and answers of this lesson in a PDF form and just write it and complete it. Okay. So this is it for today. In tomorrow's class, we will revise the lesson number 5, that is Indian villages. And in that lesson, we will discuss about the villages, about the types of villages, and about the gram panchayat. Okay. So, there are three lessons. Still, there are three lessons, like lesson number 5, Indian villages, lesson number 6, local self-government, lesson number 7, that is Indian lifestyles. So, if we revise all of these three lessons, the syllabus of this semester will finish. Okay. So, read in your home properly. Soon, we are going to conduct the examinations on the basis of all these chapters. And of course, we will face 20 questions, and for each question, there is one mark. and 30 minutes you will get to answer all of those questions. Questions will be in multiple choice questions. For one question, you will get 4 options like A, B, C, D. You have to put the correct one for the correct answer. Okay. So yes, this is it for today. We will continue with the tomorrow.